Your Excellency, what were the reasons for the American investments in these cultural projects?
Well, the U.S. Department of State, the U.S. government generally, is very supportive of cultural programs throughout the world. And as I said in my statement earlier, we believe that one important way to strengthen ties between countries is to recognize and cultivate and restore and appreciate the cultures of different countries. And that brings a recognition on the part of our government and your government of the value that each of us bring to the world community.
Why right here in Alba Iulia?
Well, because there's a fascinating historical resource right here in Alba Iulia, which I've just spent an hour reviewing, with 2,000 years of history and artifacts that trace your culture back 2 millennia. That's why.
Have you ever been before here
not
in our
to
town?
Alba Iulia. I've been to Cluj, but not to Alba Iulia.
Are there any similar projects in which the American Embassy is involved?
Oh yeah, we've done about 6 or 8 of these projects over the last 2 or 3 years. We just approved one in the Bucharest neighborhood involving a Romanian Orthodox church. We did one involving the Roma culture as well. So we've done a number of these. The embassy can provide you with a list.
In a few words, when do you think the economic crisis will end, and what will be its consequences?
In a word, I think it's going to end probably next year sometime, but I think there will be modest growth in Romania. I think Romania must make the difficult decisions that it's in the process of making right now in Bucharest, including the budget cuts. As you know, your government collectively made the decision to borrow over $20 billion worth of euros. The conditions that are being implemented now were clearly understood from the beginning. Every political party was involved in that decision one way or another, either in making the decision to borrow the money or making the decisions that led to the need to borrow the money. So it's a collective decision, and it needs to be made, and it needs to be made now. Once those decisions are made, it will help Romania's economy recover quicker and will restore and retain the credibility of the Romanian economy and its currency.
Do you think that these are the right decisions to make for the Romanian people that the government made?
That's not for me to say. I mean, that's for the Romanian parliament to say as to whether there should have been tax cuts or budget cuts. All I know is that they had to keep their deficit under a certain level, and that was required by the IMF and the other multilateral lending organizations, of which the United States is a part. And it was very important for the credibility of the Romanian government and its economy that this be done.
The U.S. dollar is getting stronger. Do you think that the U.S. economy is getting out of this economic crisis?
Yes, I do think the American economy is improving. I think you're referring to the relationship between the euro and the dollar, which is probably more a function of what's going on in the European economy than what's going on in the U.S. economy.
What is the American position regarding the mining project of Roșia Montană?
We do not have a position.
When do you think that Romanian people will be able to travel to USA without a visa?
I think when your economy begins to grow and there are fewer applications, illegitimate applications by people who are applying for travel visas when really they intend to stay, that increases your refusal rate and makes it difficult for us to give you a visa waiver permission. And I think that is getting better, but it's largely a function of your economic growth and improvement. You see, the real problem with visa waiver is the U.S. Congress has a rule that says that if more than 3% of the people that apply are actually applying for the wrong visa, pretending like they're going over on travel but really going over there to stay for a long time, then we can't grant you visa waiver. And I think a lot of people are applying for these visas And they're applying over and over again and getting rejected over and over again. That's driving that rate up. And it's because they really want to come live in the United States rather than just visit the United States. And I think that will change as your economy improves, as people learn that they can flourish here in Romania or maybe live elsewhere in Europe. That'll mean that refusal rate will go down, and I think eventually you'll get in the visa waiver program. I'm very hopeful about that.
When do you think that it will happen?
I think it'll depend, as I said, on how quickly your economy recovers and how soon people stop applying over and over again. I've been working with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs to improve that program by encouraging people not to keep applying over and over again. Because every time someone applies one, two, three, four times, and they get rejected to one, two, three, four times, it drives up that rate. And then Congress looks at it and says, we can't grant that. If people would stop applying over and over again, knowing that they're not going to be accepted, that rate would go lower and you would eventually get in.
What is your perception concerning the corruption in Romania?
It's getting, the rule of law and transparency and prosecutions are getting better. There's still a lot of work to be done. As you know, I've been a strong advocate of restoring the ANI statute. I think that's you cannot have an anti-corruption regime without a financial disclosure regime. No modern democracy has been able to do that. You need to do it. It was a condition of your entry into the EU. And I am encouraged by the position the government is taking on this, which seeks to revise that statute in a narrow way to meet the concerns of the Constitutional Court. Now, I think there are also reforms that need to take place in your judiciary. The World Bank has given you, I think, 100 million euros or dollars, a lot of money, to reform your judiciary. That money needs to be spent. We need to encourage these new reformist younger judges to move up in the system. I've met a lot of young judges who are strong advocates of reform. We're upset with the Voicu case and a number of these other cases, and I'm encouraged by that. You have a very good set of prosecutors here who are pursuing cases. I'm very impressed with them. We are providing a lot of help, technical assistance to your law enforcement and prosecutors. We've had tremendous success, the FBI and your law enforcement people, on cybercrime. So I'm encouraged. I think that it's all moving in the right direction.
So do you think that Romania has the necessary resources to get over this crisis?
It has the resources. The real question is, does it have the fortitude? Does it have the courage to make the decisions necessary to confront problems of corruption? And I'm seeing encouraging signs, but I'm still watching.
Your Excellency, thank you very much. Excelența voastră, cum a început acest proiect?
Dacă să nu încep cu făurirea lumii, încep cu faptul că fiecare catedrală, atât de venerabilă și antică ca și a noastră, are nevoie de o restaurare, reînnoire permanentă. Lucrările s-au continuat și în urmă cu 100 de ani, au fost începute și reîncepute și acum, de 10 ani, Fundația Hieronymus, în frunte cu doamna arheologă Dana Marcu Istrate, au luat toate obiectele, uneltele, monezile găsite la săpături, făcute în jurul catedralei și în catedrală, și astfel s-a născut ideea că aceste peste 40 de obiecte găsite dintr-o perioadă de 1700 de ani trebuie să fie puse și la îndemâna turiștilor, vizitatorilor, cercetătorilor. Și asta s-a născut ideea, să facem o expoziție permanentă, cel puțin 4518 obiecte au fost identificate, curățite, cataloghizate și, cum spunea și doamna în cuvântul său de inaugurare a expoziției, a dat câte o carte de identitate fiecărui exponat. În expoziție fac parte numai câteva sute de obiecte, însă cu explicațiile date în trei limbi pentru ca să fie înțeles de toți vizitatori. Și această expoziție, așa cum spunea și domnul director, tot într-un cuvânt de inaugurare, o cercetare de săpături și catalogizare de 10 ani s-a încheiat și să punem un punct pe i, dar spunea, e mai vârtos, e mai bine să spunem că punem o virgulă, pentru că lucrările atât la catedrală cât și la Palatul Medieval Episcopal, postprinciar, tot continuă.
Cum s-a ajuns la această colaborare cu Ambasada Statelor Unite ale Americii?
Când noi am solicitat Fundația Hieronymus să preia lucrările de specializare, pentru că doamna Ana Marcu este acreditată de stat și de Direcția Monumentelor Istorice și pe plan științific este pe culmea activității sale profesionale, dânsa ne-a propus ca să înaintăm un proiect la Consiliul Cultural al Ambasadei Statelor Unite ale Americii la București. Pentru că fiecare ambasadă a Statelor Unite în fiecare țară are și câte un consiliu cultural pentru ajutorarea conservării și expunării și catalogizării obiectelor culturale. E foarte interesant că Statele Unite are mare interes în această conservare a obiectelor nu arhaice, ci adică de regăsite la săpături arheologice. Sunt unii care explică acest fapt prin interesul americanilor sosiți abia în lumea nouă, în secolul XVI, după descoperirea Americii, că au un interes mai mare decât europenii când văd niște rămășițe sau cetăți medievale care nu există în America de tip european. E clar că în America existau atâtea culturi a indigenilor, autohtonilor, care sunt acum și ele, și ne bucurăm că păstrate și conservate în măsură în care s-a putut.
Spuneați că finalizarea acestui proiect nu este un punct, ci o virgulă. Cum vor fi continuate lucrările în acest sens?
Aceste săpături s-au terminat, însă renovarea, restaurarea catedralei se continuă. De exemplu, acum suntem și cu sanctuarul și cu apsida catedralei, e cu schele, iar la Palatul Princiar mai sunt părți, care, adică fațada deja a fost renovată, însă sunt părți care au nevoie încă de o reînnoire sau o restaurare așa mai fundamentală.
Excelența voastră, vă mulțumim foarte mult pentru timpul acordat.
Mulțumesc pentru posibilitate.